Hi everyone, this is Leonard, and today we are talking about RPM filters in Betaflight. The first two videos of this series covered the basic principles of Betaflight filters and also the tools we use for filter tuning. It is now time to cover the specific impact of the settings. In this video, I will tell you what RPM filters are, why they are very important, and also all the settings related to them. Everything you need to know about this amazing feature right after the logo. RPM filters are specifically designed to track and eliminate the noise coming from your motors. They are actually made of a bunch of dynamic notch filters. But what does this mean? A notch filter eliminates noise around a specific frequency. It is different from a low-pass filter that will reject all the noise above a given frequency. Now, a dynamic notch filter is able to move and follow a frequency. The noise generated by your motors depends on how fast they are spinning. Generally speaking, if you increase the throttle, the frequency will be higher. But all four motors are not always rotating at the same speed. Typically, during a flip or a roll, two of them will spin faster and the other two slower. This is why the base of RPM filters is made of four dynamic notch filters that will track each motor individually. And to be able to do that, they simply use the telemetry from your ESCs to know the rotating speed or RPM from each motor in real time. This is the magic ingredient that makes this filtering method so precise and efficient. It allows us to rely less on other Betaflight filters that would give us more phase delay. Before going into Betaflight, the last thing I would like to explain is the concept of harmonics. I will make it very simple. Any frequency, or in this case a vibration, will generate another vibration of a smaller amplitude at a multiple of its frequency. So you will see a peak at 2 times the original frequency, 3 times, and so on. And these are called the harmonics. Luckily for us, RPM filters also take care of them. If you don't know how to activate RPM filters, here is a quick reminder. If you have BL-Heli 32 ESCs, you can enable bidirectional D-shot on the configuration page. Below that, you need to enter the amount of poles of your motors. You can find this value on the manufacturer page or by counting the number of magnets inside your motor. Then you will see the RPM filters on the filter page. If you have BL-Heli S ESCs, there is still a way to get this, but you will need to use JESC or Jazz Maverick. Since I haven't used any of them yet, I can't cover the subject, but you can find all the information online and, for example, from Joshua Bardwell, who made a video specifically on these two firmwares. The next step was already covered in my first video of the filter series, but I will quickly go through it. The default settings of the dynamic notch filter are designed to track the motor noise. Since we are now using the RPM filters, we can lower the dynamic notch to track any other undesirable noise in the lower frequencies by using these settings. Okay, we are all set now. The first setting of the RPM filters is the amount of harmonics you want to filter. You can enter a value between 1 and 3. 1 means that you only filter the base noise of your motor, called the first harmonic or the fundamental. A value of 2 will also filter the second harmonic, and of course, a value of 3 will filter the first, second, and the third harmonic. If you use Blackbox Explorer, you can generally see clearly the motor noise. If everything is right with your quadcopter, the motors will be the biggest source of noise. In this example, we can see a huge bump that will be my motor noise. Depending on the amount of throttle, the noise will be situated in this range of frequencies. And just a reminder of what the Betaflight filter system will do to all that noise, boom, almost nothing is left after filtering. But using Pit Toolbox can give you an even better visual representation of the harmonics. As we know, the motor noise frequency goes up as we increase throttle. This is why the motor noise will be displayed as a diagonal line. And with the harmonic rule, we can also understand why there is another line that is always 2 times higher than the fundamental frequency. Back to Betaflight, what value should we use for the harmonics? In most cases, the default value of 3 will be very good to cover all your potentially problematic harmonics. It is a conservative value, but it allows us to rely less on the low-pass filters, because this is generally the only noise that we will see in the higher frequencies. Reducing the amount of harmonics will result in less phase delay, which would be useful for a more optimal tune because it will deactivate some filters. But reducing it to 2 harmonics won't give you enough payoff. So let's compare the default value of 3 straight to only 1 harmonic, which means only filtering the bass motor noise. As we can see in this comparison graph, there is a bit more noise left in the higher frequencies after filtering only 1 harmonic. Actually, I have to change the scale to really show the difference. Higher frequencies and harmonics will eventually get filtered by the low pass. So we could see this change as a win, right? Because the quad still flies fine and we reduced the amount of filters. But as I said, our goal when tuning the filters is also to find the best strategy to get the most performance. So using the RPM filters with 3 harmonics could allow us to reduce or deactivate the gyro low pass, for example. So there is no straight answer, because it depends on your quad and also on other Betaflight filter settings. For optimal filtering, leave the default value of 3 harmonics. But if you can't even see any other harmonics in your logs and you really want less filtering, reducing it to 1 will not hurt. The other setting on this section is the minimum frequency. Any other setting in Hertz on the filter page will allow you to change the amount of filtering and reduce your phase delay if you increase the frequency. But this one is totally different. It will prevent the RPM filters to go lower than that value, which would be way too low. It actually doesn't matter, because when you fly, you will always be above that frequency. So just leave that to default. There is one last important setting. At this time, with Betaflight 4.2, it is actually hidden in the CLI. It is the RPM notch cue. You can type get gyro RPM notch cue to see it. The default value is 500, and you can use a value between 250 and 3000. When I explained how notch filters worked in the beginning of this video, I didn't mention the cue value. This is actually what defines the width of a notch filter. A lower Q value will increase the width, and the higher Q will make it thinner. It will also have an impact on your phase delay, since filtering a wider range of frequencies will result in a bigger phase delay. In this specific case, be careful though. We are working on a dynamic notch, which moves with the target frequency. If we make it too thin, it could actually miss the noise by being slightly offset, and it wouldn't work efficiently. So it is not recommended to increase that value. But I can see a case where decreasing the value could be useful. If you still see a lot of motor noise after filtering the signal, a wider notch could be a good solution. You can change it by typing set gyro RPM notch cue and then the value of your choice. I tried a comparison on a Cinewhoop that still has a lot of noise after filtering. On the left, the cue is set to 500 and on the right, 250. We can see that there is less noise on the second test, and it would be very hard to get rid of that with other filters. But in general, the default value of 500 is once again a pretty good compromise. Here is a bonus part. This is not really a setting, but did you know that you can actually record what the RPM filters are doing? If you use the debug mode RPM filters in the black box tab, you will be able to record the frequencies targeted by the RPM filters. In Black Box Explorer, the debug graph will now show the 4 values which correspond to the 4 motors. And if you display the motor's output at the same time, you can actually see how the frequencies are linked to the RPM. I know that RPM filters don't have a lot of room for tuning because of how good they are on default, but I think it is really useful to understand how all of this works. You should also make sure they filter most of the noise before diving deeper in the Betaflight filters. I also hope you realize how important they are in the filtering process. If you learned something with this video, or if you still have any questions, just leave a comment. This series will also cover all the filter settings, so if you don't want to miss the next video, make sure to subscribe. Once again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.